start off 5 years after the first story ended. As new hero Roach Sanderson, you will go from one location to the next in the hopes of taking down a Russian lunatic, Vladimir Makarov. And as the hours pass you by, you realize that this game is insane. In story mode, you are thrown from one crazy explosive situation to the next. And if you don't take cover, say hi to Shiva for me. Yes, the game is difficult and may throw in a few cheap kills here and there due to a billion spawning terrorists. But fans of COD franchise will still cry bloody tears of joy. The story is not as good as the first game and the finish is just as best. But it is still very entertaining. The ending could definitely be better though. What happens is just... I'm just kidding, no spoilers for me. Gameplay is still very tight, if not more so. Now you can carry two primary weapons, even dual-wield handguns. This carries over to multiplayer, which is even more frenetic with new modes and features. Multiplayer also grants new bonuses for in-game awesomeness. Long kill streaks are rewarded with missile strikes and even a nuke to be used in the game. So if you are a noob, you will die. The graphics of the game are not groundbreaking, but they have smoothened it out a bit from Call of Duty 4. And even more surprising, the 60 FPS frame rate never drops even when the screen is raining men. I think I should use another reference. Hans Zimmer's music is rousing and explosive effects will make you realize if the PMA is right for you or not. But really, it is pretty good, especially the voice acting. Very solid work here.